guess what, people? It was a sad time. It was a sad time to see the NightHawks go. Oklahoma City NightHawks, Madden 22 franchise series, had to say peace out. Only because we have a new thing coming, and here it is. Yep, we're gonna create a league. Use real life NFL roster. But it is gonna be offline. Offline preseason roster. And what we're gonna do, as posted in many of the socials that I'm on, this series is going to be entirely relocated franchises. Every single team is going somewhere new. Some of them a little bit more out there than others. But I guess the question is going to be, where do we end up? There's a reason that I'm about to pick the team I'm going to pick. But while we do this process, I do want to remind everybody, if you want to see your name as one of the players, all you got to do is speak up in the chat, or subscribe, send me a message on one of my socials, anything like that. Yeah, that's not what I wanted. Because what we're going to do, first of all, is delete that. That's not what I wanted. We're going to create an offline team. Yup. But not only is it going to be entirely relocated franchises, we're also going to be doing a fantasy draft. So this is where I messed up. Starting point. Fantasy draft. Change role. Nope. Sticking with head coach, because now head coach can not only do the relocations, but are still eligible for the breakout scenarios that we missed out on because they didn't integrate those two things. We'll get to custom coach when we come back around, and let's go ahead and set some league settings because some of these are permanent. For example, bam, game style, arcade, just like last time. We'll do 8 minutes. No accelerated clock. Don't have to worry about that. No offensive play call, limits. I really try to do what is feasible as a coach, as a play caller. So, bam, turning off that stupid home field advantage. If you can't pick and choose what they are, then you are at the mercy of wherever you're playing. And since we're not exactly sure if or what the benefits are to everything else, then we might as well not even worry about it. Going to a different location and all. Manual. Any of these that I don't want manual? Nope. I want them all. All right, we got practice reps. No, I'll pick them from time to time. Reorder depth chart, for the love of God, don't touch my depth chart. I do it on purpose where I'll get in a rookie and I want them to succeed and elevate. All right, no echo, thank goodness. I want the rookies to succeed and elevate, so I put them in as starters, and they may not be the best players. I don't want Madden touching those things. Auto progress players, off. Leave that to me. Talents, off. Leave that to me. Tutorial pop-ups, off. Can't be that much different. It's the same Madden every year, isn't it? Trade deadline, on. Trade type, all. Trade difficulty, we'll do normal for now. We'll change that if necessary. Salary cap, on. Free agent motivation, impact, normal. What are the other options here? Yeah, normal. We'll see what that is, and then as we get used to how it works, we might change a few things. Practice squad stealing. Sure. Here's the important one. Everyone can relocate because everybody will. Staff talent cost modifier. We'll do that for now. Injuries on. Practice injuries on. Pre-existing injuries on. Progressive fatigue on. Prospect storyline on. Draft timer off, just in case. Fantasy draft order, snake, man! Free agent negotiations on stage one. Why is there even a limit? 10-10, good buddy. And then unlimited, sure, why not? League type. All, coach firing. On. If I get fired, it's because I deserve to be. Full on-field control. Set to on, you'll be able to control all players on the team. Duh. Instant starter. Duh. Career clock. Sure. Breakout scenarios. Yeah. Development trait regression. Sure. Desired X-Factor dev players. Not touching it. That's how I love what those are. Superstar abilities. On. Sure. Ability edit controls. I'm the only player here. Minimum roster size. We'll actually bump that up to 49. The more players that we have the ability to depth, basically. If you've seen a lot of the other franchise videos, you'll see that injuries are constant, and plentiful. So let's see. In-season player movement limit. Unlimited. Player overall cut restriction. No restriction. Off-season player cut limit, don't worry about it. And then fill roster. Off. All right, let's head back. I've got so many faces in my Twitch chat right now staring at me, I don't know what to do. Except wave back and hope that they don't, you know, go all office space on me over a red stapler. Starting point. We're good. We got the fantasy draft. We're a coach. We changed the lead settings. And we are the Miami Dolphins. Fantasy draft. Start your league with a fantasy draft. Yup. We gonna do this. So, I put starting point. Oh, yeah. Fantasy draft. Yeah. I thought I clicked that. Okay, so once we're done with the fantasy draft, which I don't know how many times I have to tell them I want to do my fantasy draft, demand my release, we will then go and do every team and relocate. That's going to be a process. I might make that a separate video. Not every team at this point. Round one pick 13. You know what? I'm not too upset with pick 13, but I do want to see what the pick before us was. And you can't, like, hold, like right here, what's the matter with pressing L2 and R2 to go back and forth to see what, whatever, make selection. So what I want is a young, amazing talent, okay? I wanted to start off, if I had the opportunity to start off, I would have went with Justin Jefferson, who probably went first overall. I wouldn't have been surprised. But what's Myles Garrett? How old is he? 27? I anticipate this franchise to be a five-year thing. Like right now, Aaron Donald's, what, 32? Started with 31, yeah, 32. So obviously, like Jamar Chase might not be a bad idea, right? Oh, I can't hold it. Okay. Can I go by drafted already, or is only what I drafted? Okay. So overall grade of these, Myles Garrett 27. I'm probably going to use him for the last 5 years of his contract. He's 29 already. He's going to start regressing in 2 years. I do want a line, a good one, and I'm going to need it because I am... There are many people better than me. Congratulations. It's not a high bar. That's not. So again, 27, so I can go in one of those directions. Plus, I do pick again shortly. So in terms of, for example, running backs, I mean, what? Josh Jacobs is 25. Christian McCaffrey, 27. If I could get Josh Jacobs on the come around, that would be amazing. I wouldn't pass that up. Saquon Barkley, he's finishing up his rookie contract, 26. So of those two, I would not mind either one coming back to me. Now, in terms of wide receivers, though, Cooper Kupp's getting up there. Stephon Diggs is, what, 28, 29? Tyreek Hill is, what, 27? Oh, goodness. Yeah, see, at this point, getting a top-flight wide receiver who is young, that opportunity is going to pass us by pretty quickly. So, DeAndre Hopkins, I was thinking about getting the Oilers-colored jersey for my boy D-Hop. 27 with Superstar X Factor. Superstar X Factor, AJ Brown. So, he was 26. Jamar, Superstar X Factor, 23. You know what? Yeah, because we're going to get one of those running backs on the way back. I'm happy with that. Really wish I could see what everyone else was drafting. But yeah, taking a look at the running backs, who do we say? So Josh Jacobs is still on here, and he's 25. Now, I'm going to get him, unless... Oh, Jonathan Taylor's on there too. And while he might be being traded, 24 only superstar, I'd rather have a 25-year-old with... Superstar X Factor. Let's go ahead and draft. Boom. We have our primary offensive players. Now, I know a lot of you don't agree with this, but I'm going to be leaving my quarterback for way later. My chat recommended Peyton Manning. Not that late. I'm pretty sure his Madden rating is purple. So, worried about that. Now that we're in the third round, we're late third round, early fourth. So that's the snake draft format. 34, oh God, 35. I don't want to wait too long on young. I'm not expecting to do a lot in the first year. That's why I want young people. And I'm willing to sacrifice a little bit at the overall if it'll come back to me in age. So like right here, 26 star development, he might even come back to me, so I'll keep an eye on him. What was that, Jordan Mailata? It's either him or Quentin Miller. Yeah, so Jordan Mailata is 26, so one of those two guys, him or Quentin Miller, should come back to me in the next round. No worry, you know. Quentin Nelson? Are you kidding me? 27-year-old superstar, 92 overall, Quentin Nelson. I mean, I got him in the Oklahoma City franchise as well, and that was a steal. I mean, I don't even have to question that. Welcome. I don't want to say welcome to the Dolphins because you don't know. But I will say that's enough on offense for a while, unless Frank Ragnarok, Creed Humphrey, 25 years old, 27 years old, 25 and over, and 90 overall. Sorry guys, as you can tell, I like to invest in my life. I don't care if I reach, my line will be solid, and right tackle is going to be so important too. But I have to pass it to get to the defensive players, but it's already, all right, there are hardly any 90s left, okay? So at this point, these guys are all good. Ooh, that's a right guard though. Oh, I wonder how many people are screaming right now, get to defense, get somebody on defense. But I mean, 27 years old, 86 overall, 88 pass block, I'm gonna need that. Maybe Leo Collins. I don't even know how old he is in this game now. In this game, this is the current year, so I don't know how old he is in real life. 30. Now, Mike McGlitzky. Years old, he might come back, and then Jack Conklin, I thought he was younger than that, but yeah, let's get a defensive player. The most important to have a, not stud, but for me, the most important position to have somebody, anybody, but good, is cornerback, especially in a league where you have to really be careful with other players' top positions. So in this case, I want to get somebody who I will have for 2 years. So maybe Teron Johnson isn't that bad of a pick. I know he's a normal development, but I'm not trying to develop him. I'm trying to have somebody there while I draft a cornerback in the first draft, and then maybe work him up. Ooh, Dory Jackson, 27 man-to-man star. Yeah, and they'll probably leave, because the computer thinks like I do too. They might overreach for an older player, or they might bypass an older player and go for youth, and I don't mind having one good year out of an aging out player, you know. Mario Davis, see, like right now, 34 years old, yeah, he's a superstar X-Factor, but he's going to retire this offseason. I don't want to have to replace him. I want to have some kind of continuity going forward. You know, I also wouldn't be able to trade him. So, 34. See, these guys are old. They're going to be there for a while. Like I? Older than I thought. Which, I really shouldn't be so surprised because, I mean, I feel like I've liked him for a while. So, why am I surprised that he's older? Matt Milano. Like I said, I know I'm not going to win too many games this first go-round. So it looks like 87, high 80s, mid to high 80s. So what we'll do here is go by age and see what the hot, like Bijan Robinson would be an amazing backup. But I need starters at other positions. So 87, Kenneth Walker, again, I don't need a running back. I want to get at least maybe 82. Again, Damian Pierce, I don't need a running back. 84, Javon Holland. Scheme fit, star dev. 23, free safety. Words, in order. Back. Bam. Good pick. Thank you. I knew that. Ha. Validation. Still good. CJ Stroud was picked up. And that, like I said, quarterbacks, I'm willing to wait. See what tight ends are. Ooh, my boy, man. I am all about Darren Waller this year in fantasy football. Even if he doesn't succeed in fantasy football, I am like, bro, I'm rooting for you, my man. I'm rooting for you. Him and Dawson Knox. Dawson Knox is another one that I'm all about the tight end position. And he's 26 too. That would not be a bad call. So there's a few tight ends still remaining that I'd be all right with. Who do we say? Michael Glinsky, was 28 with star development. Rob have seen. 28 is the age to beat. Alcon's like, what, 50? Still great. I mean, don't get me wrong. He's old, but he's great. So, yeah. I mean, that's such a good pick. Because what's this guy? 29? Yeah, so 27, 82 years old, star development. I don't care if I reach, Matt. Well, later on I'm going to care. So let me not be like, I don't care. I will. Let's go for defense again. I think defensive tackle would be a good thing to get in this spot. Last year we had Vita Vea, who led the league with 29 tackles for a loss. Had 99 strength, had nowhere to go. Deron Payne, 26 years old, star development. That's fantastic. 95 strength, my favorite stat. So what am I even doing? Deron Payne. What am I even doing? We'll draft you some wingmen, you know, left end, right end. Still not going for a quarterback, but I do want to look at some second string wide receivers. Jacoby Myers is out here. You can get cut from this team too. They have him listed as a deep threat though. I mean, 92 acceleration is pretty good. Zay Jones, which Zay Jones? You know, it's going to come down to speed. 91 speed, what do you got, Jacoby? 88? 87. Nah. Sterling Shepard, I don't even know how old you are. Wow, you're older than I thought. I felt like you were a rookie, like, a little while ago. Nelson Aguilar was on our team in the Oklahoma City NightHawks, and he might make a return. But for now, Jacoby Myers. I know he's 26, so I know he's younger. But we'll go ahead and get Zay Jones. Hopefully we can come back around and get Jacoby Myers. I think we're slipping a little too far from cornerback. Like, I want to draft him, but I don't want to need to draft him. You know what I'm saying? So, 28 normal dev. So, alright. So, high 70s right now. Going by age and going up, Kyler Gordon. I might rename him to Commissioner Gordon. 23, what's the age? See what some stats are. 88, 78 zone. I like his acceleration and agility. His man could use some work. He'd be a great second, maybe even third stringer. Like, we might get a high end. Is that him? No? It resorted to Isaiah Rogers Sr.? 25, 94 speed, decent zone, decent man, decent, I mean, never mind, we do. It didn't seem like I reached that much for that character anyway. Well, make selection. So, looking at our needs, we only have two wide receivers. We have a great halfback. We have a great leading wide receiver. Take a look at tight ends. Getting down. Mike Gesicki's on here. 27 years old. Yeah, Mike LaPorta and Mike Meyer on here. Greg Dulcich. Oh, Trey McBride. Okay, 23 and star for Greg Dulcich, so keep that in mind. It did it again. It's going to do that every time, isn't it? Dalton Kincaid. What rating did they give you? Hidden! Stud Finder, I'll take it. That was... I feel good about that. I don't care what his true value is. Alright, we're in pick 15. Our defense is thin, and that's all my bad. Let's look at middle linebackers. I mean, I've got two corners, a good free safety. Looks like mid to high 80s would be acceptable here. Who do we got here? Jack Campbell, and he's a scheme fit. Somebody easily renamed. The youngest 76 is Devin Lloyd. Star development, 24, 84 speed. Oh, might have fun working with him. Let's go. All right, at this point, we'll look at the top overall left in the draft. Like I said, they might be older people like Calais Campbell. He's probably only got a year or two. Adam Thielen, probably gonna retire this year. Kareem Hunt would be an excellent backup. You know, I don't have a left tackle. And I don't like the way that sits with me at this point, because left tackle is one of the really, I should have done that one before the right tackle, to be honest. So low 80s, high 70s, but I mean, Tyler Smith, 79? Normal dev, what's your strength? Bruh. Welcome. Learn some Spanish, Tyler. You're gonna need it. All right. Our offense is shaping up nicely. Okay. Right guard, you can't sleep on right guard for too long, but we can sleep one round. Wide receiver, we could probably use another good one, but Nelson Aguilar is still there. I'll give it one round. Hopefully he's still there, but just as a thank you for your contributions in the past with the Oklahoma City NightHawks. Danico Autry, 33. If he has the mentor tag, man, we'll see. 35 star, like it's at this point, no, I can't. Not yet. I'd rather have hidden development, 21, Miles Murphy. That would be, and I don't know what these development traits are. I mean, he's only 72, so let's go down a bit to see what, like, okay. Christian Barmore, 75, 24 years old, star development. That's gonna be tough to beat. So he's 75. Which I don't know, overall isn't anything. I'll be focused more on, Boogie Basham. I'll be focused more on traits and attributes in the draft. How old is Zach Sealer? 27, no. So yeah, Christian Barmore, welcome aboard. Good pick, thank you, Madden. I like how my team's shaping up. I'll tell you right now, I like it. We got studs on offense. We're going to have these people for a while. Okay. Still want youth. High 70s if we can, but still want youth. I want people that are going to be here for a while. Towards the end, once we start getting to like low 70s, where... At that point, I'm going to draft somebody who's going to be better next year anyway. At that point, we can overlook age a little bit. Maybe get somebody who's only going to be here for 1 or 2 years. Like right now, Arden Key, Tyus Bowser. And that last name might have sold him, 28. So 75 overall for a left outside linebacker at 28. Werner, 25. A better value is probably going to go sooner, so let's go ahead and get him now. Okay, at this point, what's the strat? What is the strat? You see if Bowser's still there. Tyus Bowser. See, and I'm okay. Like I said, he can be brought up and developed. Now, at this point, if my boy Nelson Aguilar, for your contributions as the Oklahoma City NightHawk secondary receiver, thank you. Now, I want to look at quarterbacks. Yeah, it's starting to get a little thin. Okay. Obviously, Matthew Stafford, he would be a one-year rental, but I don't want to get down to the Matt Ryan levels. Now, Trey Lance, he can throw and he can run and he won't retire next year, but I want to replace him. I want to already. But I can deal. I can deal for that. So I don't want to go any further. You know, I don't want Jordan Love because I'm not a Packer fan. But I think that's a great baseline. And just like he's going to be done this year, I'm going to trade him. So we have our primary quarterback, halfback. I am a fullback kind of guy, but I imagine that no one else is touching this position because the best people are already very old. CJ Ham, Andrew Janovich, Terry Blassingame, just because Titan fan, baby. And 27, not bad. But that's something I would also replace in the draft. We have our full line. But let's go ahead and get, speaking of line, our defensive line sorted out. 74 was the top. So, I mean, we're looking at what? Josh Pascal. Peyton Turner. How old are you? Like 28? You know what? Boom. I'm happy with this so far. I don't know about you guys. I don't know about you guys. But I'm liking my team. I've got players I like. So at this point, this is when I want to get, regardless of age, the best cornerback available. Now, 31 normal development, 92 speed. I can deal. Plus, he might not retire right away. And I could probably use him to mentor incoming rookies, you know, very important to me. Jason Verrett, I used to have on the San Antonio Dreadnoughts. The San Antonio Dreadnoughts. You'll see video clips on my YouTube from years and years ago. That was a very, very early build of Madden. Okay, my entire O-line except for right guard. I could use another D-tackle. I could use a strong safety. Like Adrian Phillips. Boom. Draft a new strong safety next year. So we got our two draft prospects for next year. Let's look at right guard. You're not going to be able to trade for anybody, right? So Trey Turner, who has been on my franchises before. Star development. I mean, Ryan does what? I'm only going to go with him because he's only one. He's only one overall. But I have him for a little while. And I can only draft so many positions as starters next year. So I will still want players that will be with us for a while and be serviceable. So, all right, we're getting to the point though that we can just not worry and let the computer do the rest. Tayshaun Gibson has been with me before as well. So right now, high 70s, so just in general, High 70s. Let's look for a 76, 77. The youngest set, like the youngest 75 is a wide receiver. I don't. He's super fast. I know. Quez Watkins. I know. Naeem Hines. I like the guy. Rather get something on defense. Mike Edwards, strong safety, 75, 27, star development. I love it. So we got our main quarterback. We have the offensive line. We got our star tight end. Our backup needs to be a blocking tight end, though. So either of these guys, ooh, Jonnu Smith is on here. 39, oh my God, Mercedes Lewis is 39 years old, and he's coming back into the league. Still has blocking chops. Blocking chops. So it's going to be between Jonnu Smith and Austin Hooper. Taysom Hill is listed as a tight end, thank you. And I think I'm going to go with Jonnu. I know Austin Hooper is a better fit for the team. Is he younger? Jonnu Smith's 28. They're both 28. They're both normal development. But Jonnu Smith is a Titan. Mad respect to the Titan. Defense. Only have a few more picks left to go. Defensive tackle. This is something where we need somebody back to Ndamukong Suh. Are we willing to stoop so low? No. Now, obviously, they're all going to have to be replaced next year, no matter who these guys are. So, their age doesn't really matter. You know? So, with mid to high 70 being the barometer, let's look at, like I said, my favorite stat, strength. And this guy's 77. Al Woods, come on, boy. Justin Tucker's still available? What's the matter with you people? I mean, he's only 1,000 years old. So obviously at this point, 90 or above kick power is great. But kick accuracy, so like right here, Graham Gano. Nobody compares to Justin Tucker, man. But Jake Elliott's on here, and Jake Elliott's my boy. And he's gonna be on here. So I'm gonna leave that. We have three wide receivers. Let's look at the halfbacks. And Kenyon Drake doing great things for a franchise guy. He'll just be a backup. I just need a backup. Boston Scott. Go ahead, it's time to come with JD McKissick, Amir Abdullah, Matt Breed, my Oklahoma City NightHawk buddy. Oh, you might just get it. Let's look at backup quarterbacks, like Tyrod Taylor. If something happens to Trey Lance, do I want Tyrod Taylor, who's got the speed that I don't have to change the way that I play? In which case, I don't have to get him now. He'll be there for Skylar Thompson, even. Skylar Thompson from the XFL or the AFL, played a couple snaps in preseason and a couple snaps last season. He's a dude. I'm okay with any of these backups, so I don't have to do it now. I've got two tight ends. See, like, here, one of these guys. I mean, I don't like my options, I'm going to be honest, just because
I mean, Packer. 95 speed.
If I'm only going to have him for a year. Then how important is this position? Byron Pringle, Oklahoma City NightHawks. So let's look at defense. I've got enough to fill every position. Let's look at middle linebacker though. Joe Sherbert, Jamie Collins, Christian Kirksey, guys I like. Can give the mentor tag maybe. But as a backup, you know, I mean, if Joe Sherbert's 28 and 29, you know what? So here's what we'll do. 75. Yeah, he's the best available linebacker at the moment, so let's go ahead and add him to the team. Next up, I only have one. Tayshaun's still on here, 79 overall, 33 years old. I'd only want to give him snaps to spell my current free safety, but I still want him to be good. Speed is 84. Logan Ryan's speed is 85. But he's taller as well. I mean, I got to go with the speed here. If he's going to step in, I can't have him be targeted because he's slow. Okay? Who did I say were the NightHawks? From, I know, not Naeem Hines, Matt Breida's on here. See, the best in the game are still here, but as old as they are, they're amazing. I mean, 29 and star development. You can't be mad at me. I'm making good picks. My team's going to be good next year and next year. So as it gets better and other teams age out, you know. So of the ends, left end and right end, which ones are still? Lawrence Guy, he was on my team last year. So you know what? I love this. It's like a convention. It's like a feel-good, high school reunion kind of thing. Like that feeling. Like, welcome back, my NightHawks. Julio Jones, still available. I need a fourth. Bradley Roby. Okay, now, cornerbacks. I have three. But Bradley Roby wouldn't be a bad fourth, just especially in nickel packages where I need someone to keep up with the speedster slot receivers that the other team might have. We'll make a couple more picks and then just have the computer do the rest. At this point, Justin Tucker's still on here. Tyrod Taylor is still here. Man, they took my... Hey, Stenson Bennett. Joshua Jobs, 40. It's only 28. It's weird. There are some players that they're like 30, and I'm like, really? And then there are some players who, I'm like, how is he not? Whatever. But yeah, a scrambler archetype here might just be the... So like here, it doesn't really matter. Hopefully the computer gets me somebody in line with what I've been looking, what I've already drafted. So same thing, we'll look at outside linebackers. so that we have depth. Actually, what we need depth is in the offensive line. So we'll get a backup center. Ben Jones, I wouldn't say he's a starter, but not a bad, at this point, backup. I mean, what's his strength? Never mind. You know what? Straight up, who is the strongest? 91 strength, 72 Robert Hainsey. It's either going to be Hainsey or Myers. Whichever one's, I guess, younger. Well, 25, whatever, backup. All right, at this point, we're just drafting backups, so I think the computer can do the rest of that. I'm just trying to make sure we get Rita, because he was a Nighthawk. Chris Harris Jr., I mean, you're 34. What's your speed, though? I already have two middle linebackers. Got four corners. I mean, I've got depth, although I could use another linebacker. I could always use a linebacker. How old is Christian Kirksey? I know I saw it before. 31? See, okay. My linebackers, my backup especially, I would want him to have good zone coverage. So, like, okay, so we got Joe Thomas, Matthew Adams, who's listed as zone but also a run stopper. If he's less than 31, cool. Good depth with that pick. Okay. Did somebody finally take my boy? Looks like it. So now, a backup running back is Amir Abdullah. Man, I remember the hype when he first came in and was the first 1,000-yard rusher for Detroit in quite some time. Melvin Gordon, what are you now? 30? Goodness gracious. Elusive back? No, I don't know about that. Not because he's not elusive, but because I considered him more a power back, I suppose. Now, Ty Montgomery is a wide receiver, is what he is. Jamichael Hasty, Duke Johnson. Tariq Cohen still on here. Demetric Felton. So yeah, it looks like Jamarcus Hasty is probably... Jamichael Hasty. Decent enough speed. He's a backup. So yeah, we'll do that. Sorry, Burrito. I had you in my thoughts. But apparently not my prayers. Okay, best players available, probably in the low 70s at this point. So we can probably have the computer do the rest, and then we'll take a break and do... Do I want Chris Harris, though? 87 speed. You know, let's go by speed. And what do we have here? Wide receivers. Tyquan Thornton is... That's a lot of speed. This is a lot of speed and a lot of acceleration and a lot of agility. Plus, I really don't care about jumping all that much for my wide receivers because I have my... This is going to be a depth piece, right? So I'm not looking for him to be the one I throw the ball to in critical situations. So, playmaker? Yeah, okay. That was a really good pick. We got kind of lucky on that one. Dwayne! Quarterback, cornerback. I was gonna say, I put it in order of development trait, and he comes up first. I'm like, he don't have them. Let's go. Can't do zone in this one. Yeah, look at the fastest cornerback. Hey, Philip Dorsett's on there. I think that's good right here. So yeah, at this point, I think the computer can do the rest. And yeah, we will take a quick break, come back, and work on the relocation process. Anybody who joins in, there are still a few teams that are semi-finalized, but there's still a little bit of play and give. Give and play. We picked the Miami Dolphins because they will be the team that we relocate last. So I'm going to create a save point because I'm going to make sure that I don't mess this up. I'm going to create two. I'm going to call one test. Yeah, new. We'll call this one test. And save. Good. And then we're going to create another one. And that'll be the actual team. Now, you stick around and you might see all of the teams, and we'll get back to this one to see what the title will be. So yeah, come back for that and discover where we're going. All right, part two coming up soon.